So, Curtis, I see that we got this out. We opened it up. Mm-hmm. Fresh bottle. Nobody's had this before. And here you tricked me with the box where I thought we were going to get the same thing with this one.
Well, I put it in the box because I knew if you came down, you'd probably open it. And I did. If you saw it,
I don't crack open your bottles.
You start drinking from it, and you know then it would be gone. So I figured I would disguise it.
It's really burn that does that.
I don't ever break open your bottles. If they're already open, then they're free game for me. This is aged 18 years. And Andy, why don't you go ahead and try and say that again?
It says the Kurayoshi Malt Whiskey. The name of the newest distillery, Kurayoshi Distillery, a new wind of whiskey.
Wow.
How's his pronunciation?
His
Matsui Whiskey.
Nihongo wa jozu. Your Japanese is good.
Oh my gosh. I feel so good. I'm feeling embarrassed. But here you go. Let's pass this down.
Eddie's bilingual. He speaks different languages too, so.
I'm sure she's better at Japanese than I am.
He speaks Honduran flecked Japanese.
Maybe. Is that something?
It is now.
Well, I just like anime a lot.
We have the 18-year-old.
Gimme.
The burn handoff there. And
you want to hand that back over there?
Do you have any experience with this then?
Mm-mm.
You've never seen this one either.
No, well I have because we have the 10, the 12, and the 18.
Yes, you
do.
And I believe
this is the 18 then, right?
Yeah, this is it was the first like multi-age statement Japanese whiskey we've had in probably a couple of years. So this is pretty exciting to have that.
Not that long ago, we did the Arbeg thing, and I think this reminds me of Arbeg just a little bit.
I think it has like quintessentially Japanese scents, and I'm gonna try not to sound like a jerk here, but to me, it smells like lychee,
mm-hmm.
and it also smells like pink peppercorns. So you kind of get a peppercorn, but it's like a little softer. So
you know, I've been for a long time trying to figure out what that was, and it's lychee.
What's lychee?
I've been trying to figure it out, and you nailed it. It really is.
Yeah,
what's lychee?
Lychee's, it's a little tropical fruit. It's kind of fuzzy, and you peel off the skin inside. It looks like kind of like a white nut. So it looks like macadamia nuts, but then it's, you know, it's fleshy, and when you bite into it, it's kind of juicy. And all I can think of to describe it is it has a tropical flavor.
And I like the sweetness of it. It's a lot more sweeter than I thought it was going to be. And it's a little dry, but not in a bad way.
Mm. Sweet.
I really like it.
Yeah.
Wow.
This would also be a good entry level to somebody who had never had PD, like whiskey.
Yeah.
And it'd be like, here, try this.
Because it's light for a PD.
It is.
But yet it has that refined whiskey flavor.
But the smoke hangs on a little bit with you. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, but the entry level and the price point, I don't think that is
true. Well, you want to impress a girl.
It's also 50%, so it is a little bit hotter.
But it doesn't hit you like most.
No, it does not.
Yeah.
No, I think the dryness kind of covers that heat up a little bit, and you're kind of like, the flavors are kind of distinct. I don't know what those are. But I can kind of see everything that's going on. This one's like pretty light, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's like, I don't know what I'm really tasting sometimes, but you know.
They're both amazing.
They're great.
Yeah, there's the contrast of them is what makes them. To me, I think these are both very amazing.
Yeah, this was a wonderful. Good contrast of, you're right. You're saying exactly right, what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
What else do you guys got?
I was thinking about, do you guys know about Mizuwari style, which is the, so.
Let us know.
I only know the word style.
When you guys drink like a whiskey or scotch and you add a little water to it to open it up, mm-hmm. in Japan there's Mizuwari style where they make a highball out of it, where they put ice and they put club soda on it, which to us, this is great. Is this the crystal skull?
It's the skull of death.
Yeah.
No. Yeah, the crystal skull of death. If anybody wants water in their whiskey, that's
we're good. As far as, no, I think it's perfect the way it is. But they will put perfectly chiseled ice cubes, like the craftsmanship that goes into like ice cubes that they do. And then they'll put like club soda in it. And it's supposed to, like you're not supposed to stir it too much because the bubbles will like change the thing. But it's basically their equivalent of the way we put water in whiskey, but they serve it as a highball because, once again, back in the day, a highball used to be a mark of disposable income for like salary men in Japan, where they'd be like, okay, I can afford this whiskey, and you know what, we're going to extend it, and we're going to add a little ice, we're going to add a little water to it, and we're going to sip on it. Something you could have in the middle of the day, where you could drink it and you're not going to get too drunk. It's something that was going to be refreshing. It was something you could have with a meal. And so I think it would be interesting to try it that way, even though it seems totally blasphemous to put this on ice with like club soda and straw.
I was going to say that.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
I have done that where I take whiskey just for the fun of it and just put ice and soda, and it just changes the whole thing.
Yeah.
It's not exactly expensive whiskey. It's just whatever.
But imagine that on, well, like on a day like today where it's really hot, where you got like ice and, you know, a little club soda, and it would be really refreshing.
Well, knew Courtney was going to be here.
Right.
And I thought, well, we have to do something special
for
Courtney.
We got to go explode the roof.
Absolutely. I mean, so since Courtney was coming, where'd it go? There it is, right here.
I ran away.
What's this?
Courtney.
Distilled from rice product. It's rice whiskey. This is very exciting. This is very new to like the United States, or at least it's not widely known. And I mean, rice is their biggest product. And so, why not make whiskey out of what you have the most of? But it's true. That's the logic behind it. So this is exciting because I have no idea what the flavor profile would be of this at all.
I don't either. And I thought, wow. And this was 2017, one of the top 20 whiskeys in the world. Mm-hmm. This particular bottle. Yeah.
Wow.
So
Fukano?
Yeah.
So I'm looking forward to this one. Because again, you know, we tried stuff from India. We've tried stuff from all...
Yeah, let's pause, and then we'll...
Yeah, that's really...